press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update from EDITORIAL247. Bell icon dabaiye, EDITORIAL247 ki sari notifications paiye. EDITORIAL247, government job in your pocket. Good morning, friends. Welcome to the Hindu editorial discussion on your own channel, that is EDITORIAL247. My name is Antara, and let us start discussing all the important editorials from the Hindu newspaper. Before starting the session, don't be busy, be productive. It means you must see people around your environment jo aap se ye kehte hai ki bahut busy hai, time nahi hai, but busy is another thing and being productive is another thing. So do not just be busy but be productive. Output aana chahiye aur jab tak output nahi aata hai tab tak kuch dikhta nahi hai. Doesn't matter how hard you try, doesn't matter how hard you work. Chaliye aage badhte hain aur dekhte hain aaj kaun kaun se articles hame yahan pe discuss karna hai. So the first article that we are going to discuss today is a maritime stretch. Now if you have seen, अगर आपने देखा होगा कि अभी रिसेंटली हमारे प्रधानमंत्री जी द प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया इज़ ऑन अ 3 नेशन विजिट इन द साउथ ईस्ट एशियन नेशंस, तो उससे रिलेटेड ये आर्टिकल है. क्या हम लोग का कॉमन कंसर्न है, दैट इज़ चाइना. क्या हमारा फ्यूचर अपॉर्चुनिटीज़ है, दैट इज़ व्हाट ऑल कैन वी डू बेटर इन टर्म्स ऑफ मिलिट्री अचीवमेंट्स, दैट इज़ जो हम लोग एक दूसरे के साथ मिलिट्री एक्सरसाइज करते हैं, इन टर्म्स ऑफ इकोनॉमिक कोऑपरेशन, इन टर्म्स ऑफ मोर ट्रेड विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू द मलाक्का स्ट्रेट्स. इन सभी चीज़ों के बारे में यहाँ पर इन डिटेल डिस्कस किया गया है. दिस इज़ गोइंग टू बी आर प्राइम फोकस टूडे. इसके बाद हम बात करेंगे ग्रीन पुश, विच इज़ अगेन ऑन हाउ यू कैन बिल्ड फ्यूअल फ्रॉम ग्रीन एलिमेंट्स, दैट इज़ अगर आप बात करो कि आप किस तरीके से इथेनॉल बना सकते हो विद द हेल्प ऑफ वेजिटेटिव वेस्ट, या फिर हमारे यहाँ पे जैसे स्टोरेज फैसिलिटीज़ अगर इतना अच्छा नहीं है तो कुछ क्रॉप्स जो है वो डिस्ट्रॉय हो जाते हैं, तो उनको फेंकने से अच्छा है कि हम उससे क्या बनाएं, बायोफ्यूल्स बनाएं. सो इट इज़ टॉकिंग अबाउट ग्रीन पुश. द नेक्स्ट आर्टिकल हियर इज़ द ट्रांजिशन टेस्ट. नाउ द मेन फोकस एट दिस मोमेंट इज़ अबाउट द गिलगित बाल्टिस्तान इशू, जिसको अभी पाकिस्तान अपने अंदर करने जा रहा है, अबाउट विच मोस्ट प्रोबेबली वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग इन अ सेपरेट आर्टिकल इन अ सेपरेट सेक्शन. बट हियर द ऑथर इज टॉकिंग अबाउट द ट्रांजिशन स्टेट. अभी वो लोग फिर से इलेक्शन मोड पे आ गए हैं, सो देर इज़ अ केयर टेकर प्राइम मिनिस्टर हु इज़ गोइंग टू टेक केयर ऑफ ऑल द इशूज. देन द नेक्स्ट इज डेटा इन पोस्ट ट्रूथ एज. हमारे यहाँ पर मैथमेटिक्स में ऑलरेडी लाइक कहा है ऑथर ने दैट वी आर वीक, सो हाउ इज़ गवर्नमेंट स्टेटिस्टिक्स रिलायबल, किस हद तक वो रिलायबल है. देन महालोबोनिस मॉडल के बारे में शी हैज टॉक, तो बहुत ही अच्छी तरीके से प्रॉब्लम क्या है, सोल्यूशन क्या है, इस एस्पेक्ट से बात किया गया है. वी विल टॉक अबाउट द सेम. वी विल नॉट डिस्कस अबाउट दिस आर्टिकल दैट इज स्ट्रेस एंड डिसऑर्डर आर इंक्रीजिंग इन द पार्लियामेंट. द नेक्स्ट वन हियर इज अबाउट फेसिंग मॉब फ्यूरी. यहाँ पे मॉब जो है, मॉब लिंचिंग के बारे में अगर बात करें, रिसेंटली यू मस्ट हैव सीन दैट वॉट इज इनसाइड समबडीज फ्रिज, उस चीज को लेके इन द केस ऑफ द कॉपर प्लांट इन तमिलनाडु विच इज़ नाउ क्लोज्ड, वहाँ तक वॉट अ कॉमन मैन फेसेस. एक गार्ड जो वहाँ पे गार्ड का काम करता है, उसके पास एक सेकेंड हैंड बाइक था जिसको मिला के एक साथ सारे बाइक्स के साथ जला दिया गया, फिर रिपोर्टर्स का कैमरा स्नैच कर दिया गया. सो मॉब हैज़ नो फेस, एंड सिंस द मॉब डू नॉट हैव अ फेस, सिंस वहाँ पे आप पकड़ नहीं सकते हो कि इस ग्रुप में से किसने एग्जैक्टली क्राइम किया है, कोई उसका सजा देना बहुत मुश्किल होता है, आप किसको टारगेट करोगे. सो एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ विच दिस मॉब क्राइम्स आर इंक्रीजिंग, बट दिस इज़ अ इशू ऑफ कंसर्न. या ये भी हमारे लिए एक बहुत बड़ा अभी डेमोक्रेसी में एक कंसर्न है, क्योंकि दिस लिंचिंग कैन अटैक एनीबडी एनी टाइम, राइट. कोई भी आके अगर एक ग्रुप आके किसी को मार के चला जाता है, देन हु इज़ रिस्पॉन्सिबल. सो दिस इज़ अ वेरी लाइक फियर सम थिंग दैट इज़ हैपनिंग इन दी डेमोक्रेसी. तो यहाँ पे उसके बारे में बात किया गया. दिस आर्टिकल इज़ अबाउट दी कॉपर मिल इन तमिलनाडु. चलिए बात करते हैं आर्टिकल्स के बारे में, एंड लेट अस स्टार्ट विद दी वोकैब्स फर्स्ट. द फर्स्ट वन हियर इज़ माइंड बॉगलिंग. वॉट डू यू मीन बाई माइंड, यानी कि दिमाग. बॉगलिंग मतलब कि यहाँ पे कुछ घोटाला हो गया, कुछ लोचा हो गया. सो दिस मीन्स ओवरवेलमिंग, एक्सट्रीमली सरप्राइजिंग एंड डिफिकल्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड और इमेजिन. एक ऐसा पोजिशन जब आप समझ ही नहीं पा रहे हो कि हुआ क्या है, है ना, हुआ क्या है. सो दैट इज द स्टेज ऑफ योर माइंड बॉगलिंग. इट कैन बी सरप्राइजिंग or it can be a shock, but it is a stage where you do not accept the situation, where it's very hard for you to imagine or believe ki ho kya raha hai. The next is realign. Now alignment is jab aap kisi cheez ko badhiya se arrange karte ho, that is your alignment. But what is realign? That is to change or restore to the former position, jo pehle tha, ya fir a different position. Ek naye tarike se aap isko arrange karo. So that is what you mean by realign. It can also be used with respect to opinions. Aap pehle kya sochte the, ab aap kya sochte ho. So this is how the word can be used. The next is berthing. Berth kya hota hai? Train mein berth hota hai, right? But here, berthing means accommodation for ships in berths. So ships ko agar aap berth ke hisab se lagao ek ke baad ek, so that is how you use the term berthing. Isko South China Sea ke respect mein aap use kar sakte ho, ya fir is article mein use kiya gaya hai. The next is uptick. Tick lagana, yani ki haan, sab sahi hai, thik hai. Then what is uptick? Upar ki taraf tick lagana. So a small increase or slight upward trend, ki haan, upar ki taraf badh raha hai, that is your uptick. The next one here is stalwart. What's stalwart? It is a loyal, reliable and hardworking supporter of a participant in an organization or team. Say for example, yahan is team mein, Adda 247 ki team mein, the camera person, the technical staff, everybody is very hardworking and supporting this show. So that is how you use it. That is a loyal and reliable hardworking supporter. Theek hai? Of an organization or a team. Next dekhiye, shackle. What does shackle means? Now this word shackle is a pair of fetters connected together by a chain used to fasten a prisoner's wrist or ankle together. Nahi samajh mein aaya? Ye dekhiye, ye U shape ke is tarike se jo chain bane hue hote hai na, which is used to tie up somebody's hand, or you can say hatkari jise aap kehte ho, to usi ko hum yahan pe kya batayenge? Shackle batayenge. Next is fulcrum. What is fulcrum? A thing that plays a central or essential role in an activity, event or situation. Fulcrum is wo cheez jo ek bahut hi essential role play karta hai. Say for example, for this show, this laptop is working like a fulcrum, right? So this is how you can use it. Now let us proceed further and discuss the articles. So the first article here is, ek baar pehle hum log newspaper mein dekh lete, fir we will come to the slides. So the first one here is a maritime stretch, and this article is talking about hamare Prime Minister ji ka visit to the Southeast Asian nations, and there an uptick, see I told you about this word, an uptick in India-Indonesia relations. So that is an increase in India-Indonesia relation. So he has met his counterpart, that is in Indonesia, who is President Jokowi. And they have both talked about various issues including global maritime fulcrum and Act East policies. So, dusra kya hai? Hum dono ka common concern jo hai, wo hai China. Aur kis kis area mein hum aage chalke engagement kar sakte hai? As a result of which, finally, kya hoga? There will be more opportunities for India, and we will develop better relationship and better power in the Indo-Pacific zone. So this is what the entire article is talking about. Now let us come into the map location and let's see kahan pe kya hai. To sabse pehle aap dekhiye, yahan pe hai China. Yahan India se 10 degree channel ke baad aap dekh sakte ho ki 10 degree channel kisko separate karta hai? Andaman and Nicobar Islands ko separate karta hai. Kaun separate karta hai? The 10 degree channel. And what is this 10 degree? This is the 10 degree latitude. Ye ho gaya sabhi SSC aur aapka RRB aspirants ke liye. That the 10 degree channel separates your Andaman. Ab dekhiye, Andaman and Nicobar se itna close hai. The next is this region of Indonesia. So you see, this is the region of Indonesia. Ab Indonesia mein ye dekhiye, there are many islands in this entire region of, you can say, the Southeast Asian region. Now we are going to look into some of the important islands. Let us start with the Paracel Island. Then you see there is sequence mein dekhiye, niche ki taraf, Spratly Island. Then you see there is Natuna Island. So this Natuna Island, ye bar bar is article mein repeat hoga. Then you see, yahan pe aapko pata hai pehle se, Kuala Lumpur hai, yahan pe Vietnam, Hanoi, then there is हाइनन आइलैंड, देयर इज फिलीपींस, दिस इज मनीला. सो ये आप यहाँ पे देख सकते हो. यहाँ पे साथ ही साथ एक्सक्लूसिव इकोनॉमिक क्लेम्स, कौन किस एरिया को क्लेम करता है. अब इस इन लाइन्स में देखिए आप, जैसे कि वियतनाम इस ग्रीन रीजन को क्लेम करता है, बट दिस इज ओवरलैपिंग विद द फिलीपींस का ऑरेंज लाइन. सो इस एरिया में मेन दिक्कत ये है कि एक तो चाइना है ही जो पूरा का पूरा साउथ चाइना सी को क्लेम कर रहा है, एंड दे हैव गिवन दिस 9 मार्क. सी दिस 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. तो ये 9 मार्क एक तो पहले से ही चाइना ने अपना बना के रखा है. ऑल्सो द रेस्ट ऑफ द रीजन्स, द रेस्ट ऑफ द लाइन्स, यू कैन सी दे आर इंटरलिंकिंग. तो मेरा टेरिटरी और आपका टेरिटरी आपस में क्लैश कर जा रहा है, एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ विच देर इज सम प्रॉब्लम्स गोइंग ऑन इन द साउथ चाइना सी ऑलरेडी दैट इज एक्जिस्टिंग. अब आगे बात करते हैं. दीज 9 लाइन्स आर नोन एज 9 डैश लाइन ऑफ चाइना. Then let us look at the Sabang port of Indonesia first, and then we will proceed further. So this is the Google map, this is India. फिर आप देखिए, इंडिया से अगर आपको साउथ ईस्ट एशिया जाना है, then you have only one way. Please observe very carefully. Now यहाँ पे एक और proposal था, Thailand बोल रहा था कि we will make, but now Thailand is not taking this seriously. So since that strait is not made, that was the proposal कि एक artificial strait बनाते हैं इधर से, तो इससे क्या हो जाएगा, साउथ चाइना सी पास पड़ेगा, पर वो अब तक बना नहीं है. सो सिंस दिस वन इज नॉट येट मेड, वी हैव ओनली वन ऑप्शन. कैसे आप जाओगे, ये देखिए, इधर से होते हुए दिस इज द ओनली रूट थ्रू विच यू कैन एंटर, राइट, एंड दिस रूट इज नोन एज द स्ट्रेट ऑफ मलाक्का. सो नाउ यू नो वेयर इज द स्ट्रेट ऑफ मलाक्का, जिस रास्ते से आप जा रहे हो. फिर आगे यहाँ पे आपको जकार्ता, बाली, ये सब आइलैंड्स आपको इस रीजन में देखने को मिलेगा, ठीक. सो आफ्टर द स्ट्रेट ऑफ मलाक्का, वंस यू हैव एंटर्ड, देन यू सी देयर आर द अदर साउथ ईस्ट एशियन नेशंस, एंड देन यू सी दिस इज द सबांग पोर्ट. This is the Sabang port, जो आपका Google Map से already highlight किया हुआ है, and this is your Indonesia. So now you know where is Sabang port and the Indonesia. चलिए अब आगे बढ़ते हैं. Now what the article is talking about, अब उसके बारे में बात करते हैं. First, in the map you have seen India से आप कैसे जाओगे, you have only one option, that is the Malacca Strait, and then you enter Indonesia, and then you enter the rest of the Southeast Asia, and then you have seen where is the Sabang port. So now what has happened, our Prime Minister Modi ji, he has visited, he is on a 3-day visit to Southeast Asian nations, where he has met the Indonesian president. That is, who is the Indonesian president, who is the president of India, his name is Jokowi. So he has met Jokowi. So what are they going to discuss? They are going to discuss about global maritime fulcrum. What is a fulcrum? That is that point from where everything else is connected. एक ऐसा फोकल पॉइंट जहां से बाकी सब चीजें कनेक्टेड है. से फॉर एग्जांपल, आई कैन से द न्यू जलपाईगुड़ी एनजेपी इज द फल्क्रम टू द रेस्ट ऑफ द नॉर्थ ईस्ट, क्योंकि एनजेपी से होते हुए, इस बॉटलनेक से होते हुए बाकी का नॉर्थ ईस्ट का सभी रेलवे लाइंस कनेक्ट होता है, ठीक है. सो फल्क्रम इज दैट पॉइंट फ्रॉम वेयर इट इज गेटिंग कनेक्टेड. सो ग्लोबल मैरिटाइम फल्क्रम विल बी दैट पॉइंट फ्रॉम वेयर the rest of the global routes are connected. We will look into the image in a couple of minutes. The next is the Act East policy. That is jo hamare Pradhan Mantri ji ne kaha tha ki look East policy, sirf dekho nahi, don't just look, just Act East policy. So that is the Act East policy, the modified version of the look East policies. Then there is maritime collaboration, that is sea lines of communication, SLOC. What is LOC, you know, line of control? This is sea lines of communication. What is SLOC? Sea lines of communication, abbreviated as SLOC, is a term describing the primary maritime routes, that is the primary, ekdam jo basic routes hai, primary maritime routes between ports used for trade, logistic, naval forces. Obviously you can use the ports for trade or whatever, you're carrying goods, that is logistics, or for naval exercises. But what is SLOC? That is any route that is connecting two ports, that is basically your sea line of communication. Jis tarike se national highway hota hai, usi tarike se ye sea line of communication hai. Next is the Indonesian government to grant access to Sabang port. See, we have access to Sabang port, that is इस मैप में देखिए, इंडिया हैव एक्सेस टू सबांग पोर्ट, Okay, so they have granted us the access. Now, this is only 100 nautical miles away from the southern tip of Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Yahan se zyada duri mein nahi hai. It is only 100 nautical miles. If 1 nautical miles is something about 1.8, then you can understand that 100 nautical miles is not very far. It is less than your something around 150 kilometers, right? So, that is how it works. The next one is for development of the port of port and economic zone. Obviously, that is the purpose. So, Sabang will fayda kya hai? It will enhance the Indian Navy's ability to maintain a forward presence and monitor movement in the Strait of Malacca. Now, please come back to this image. See, I told you that this was the only path through which there is access. This is the Strait of Malacca. Also, there was another thing, even if United Nations, even if they face a problem doing trade with the Southeast nation with respect to the Strait of Malacca, agar Strait of Malacca mein koi aapka piracy hota hai, kuch bhi aapka problem hota hai, then everybody, the entire world, they look at India with hope ki bhaiya kuch to kijiye, dekhi aapke paas hai, please sort this issue out. Now, also all the South Asian nations, they are also looking at India that please, you should maintain, you are like one of the superpowers in this region. And agar China se hum umeed nahi kar sakte, to uske baad hum kisse umeed kar sakte, hum India se umeed kar sakte. So the world is looking at us for maintaining peace in the Strait of Malacca and in the entire Southeast Asian region. For that, we need access not just to the Strait of Malacca, but also to the Sabang port. Because from here, you see, we can maintain like good naval exercise in all the region and we can maintain peace. So, isiliye jo common concern hai hum log ka China, as well as the all the piracy issues, so we can look after it with the help of Strait of Malacca. Now coming to what is the global maritime fulcrum. See, if you look at the fulcrum, then this, you see, this is India, right? Ab jaoge to aapko idhar India mein aana padega, aapko idhar se hote hue fir aage jana padega. You can't just keep on sailing, you need to rest. So this was the strait. Ab yahan pe kaun kaun sa strait aata hai iske andar? Iske andar aata hai Sunda Strait, Denpasar and Banyug Wagi Strait. So all of them are on the Lombok Strait. So if you are asked Lombok Strait kahan pe hai, then it is in the Southeast Asian region. What is a strait, by the way? Strait is any small water body that connects two big water bodies. And what is itmus? Itmus is a small land body that connects two big land bodies. Okay, so strait is if it will connect two bigger water bodies. Then next is, as a result of this, there will be economic zone. Indonesia ko kya fayda hoga is strait mein access dene se? Indonesia ko bhi kuch fayda hona chahiye. So they will get the benefit of shared economic zone in the regions of Andaman Sea. So both India and Indonesia can share this region. Then there is, India should leverage this opportunity. What are the opportunities for India? Malacca Strait patrol programs, coordinated patrol progs. So we can maintain a good navy, military base ke hisab se humko bahut zyada fayda hoga. Then there is the Navy Security Mission, Jaipura Naval Base in West Papua. So where is Jaipura Naval Base? It is in West Papua. There are further opportunities for India. Mr. Narendra Modi, he is going to deliver a keynote in the Shangri-La Dialogue in Singapore. So, wahan pe jaake wo baat karne wale. Singapore ke saath the rest of the relations are very good. The only issue is about the banking sector. Bas wahi pe hum log thoda atak rahe. Rest of the things are good with Singapore. After his Jakarta visit, and he needs to use this opportunity to make public strategic framework of the ACTIS policy. So, is pure keynote mein, he has to make it clear that the ACTIS policy is going to work in a very good way. What is the ACTIS policy? It focuses on extended neighborhood in Asia-Pacific region. Also focuses on the economy, social, cultural tie-ups, because we had been culturally close to each other since time immemorial. So all these things will develop. The social relationship, cultural relationship, then a lot many Indians are already staying in Indonesia. They have their business over there, more than a lakh of Indians. So all these things will boost up, the trade will boost up, and if these Indians will stay there, obviously they will send back money to India, as a result of which our economy will also develop. Then who are the nations in the Asian? Indonesia, Vietnam, Malaysia, Japan, Korea, Australia, Singapore, Association of Southeast Asian Nations, that is your Asian. Then to realize the potential of a strategic alignment with the archipelagic state. What is an archipelagia? That is a group of islands. So Indonesia has many of the islands in it. So this is why it is known as an archipelagic state. That is geopolitically positioned at the center of Indo-Pacific. So if you give us to the access to the Sunda Strait, then we will also have the access to the Indo-Pacific, because that is in the center of Indo-Pacific. I hope you did get through what was in this entire article. Agar samajh mein aaya, to fir like button ko hit karte hue aage chalte hain, and let us move to the next article. Now, if we can focus on the newspaper, the next article is about Green Push. So, what is this article talking about? Green Push, it is a new biofuels policy is high on ambition, but success will depend on the details. Ek naya biofuel policy hai, jiska ambition bahut high hai, itna high hai ki ye agriculture ko bhi waste nahi hone de raha hai. Agricultural waste ko se bhi ye biofuel generate karne ka baat kar raha hai, but the success will depend on the details that how it works. So that is what it is talking about. Now let's see what is there in this entire article. Theek hai? The cabinet this month approved a national policy on biofuels. Isi mahine ek aapka national policy on biofuel wapas aa jata hai abhi hamare PPT pe. Ek approve kiya hai isi mahine, which encourages generation of biofuels such as ethanol. Which of the following is a biofuel? Your answer is ethanol is a biofuel. Otherwise, you have a lot many natural resources like coal, petroleum, etc., etc. But this is a biofuel, that is any kind of biological waste or biological product. Say for example, sugarcane has to give you the fuel. Okay, even neem seeds can be used as a fuel. So that is how you have to generate the fuel. Under the new policy, feedstock for biofuel includes sugar. Pehle kya tha? Sirf sugar cane tha. But according to this new policy that was passed the last month, you can use beetroot, you can use sugar, beet, corn, damaged food grains. Aisa nahi ki abhi khane ke liye nahi mil raha hai aur aapne food grains ko bech diya. Damaged food grains, potatoes. 3 rupee bodi potatoes bikta hai in some of the states in India. So better you can use them for some other purpose. And even municipal solid waste. Municipal solid waste ko decompose karna is one of the biggest hurdle that we are facing in today's time. But if you can use this municipal solid waste for the generation of biofuels, isse achhi baat kya ho sakta hai? This will reduce the cost of production of biofuels, improve the affordability for customers. Do fayde honge, ek paise bachega aur dusra everybody can purchase it, because if you have to make biofuels from all these things, then understand you have to develop infrastructure with respect to that. So paise lagane se nahi hoga, infrastructure develop karna hoga, isse employment bhi generate hoga, and as a result of which the customer, the citizens will enjoy at a cheaper rate. Or especially ab jab Karnataka elections ke baad petrol prices fir se normal aa gaya hai, it has raised like anything, bahut zyada badh gaya hai. So I hope you understand the need of biofuel in such a scenario. So pricing is the key. Large chunks of biofuels will have to come from sugar sector now. Why? Kyun abhi sirf sugar hi kyun, potato abhi kyun nahi? Because we do not have the infrastructure. Chaliye infrastructure banate hain aur in sab se hum log biofuel generate karte hain. Paisa kitna lagega sahab? The government estimates that ethanol supply of around 150 crore liter in 2017-18 could save foreign exchange worth rupees 4000 crore. Bahar se tel khareedna, that too in a scenario when the Middle East and Iran already themselves are in crisis. So in this situation we can produce oil here itself, because we are a country that is dependent on agriculture. Hamare yahan pe mainstay of the Indian economy is agriculture. So we can use it in a better way. Hum 150 crore liter yahi pe generate kar sakte hain 2017-18 tak, and that will save us 4000 crore of rupees. So how much do you need to invest to save this 4000 crore? You need to invest 5000 crore in building the bio refineries and offering other incentives over the next few years. So if you invest 5000 crore, then you are going to save 4000 crore. But also understand, this is for only this year, right? Ek bar ke liye setup cost lagega, but in the future the biofuels, jo aapke waste hai, unko aap use karo, and at a cheaper rate you can generate. See, this is with respect to all the natural resources. Most of the natural resources jo aapke non-conventional or conventional natural resources में से अगर आप बात करें कि solar energy के बारे में, so solar setup is costly, wind energy के बारे में, wind setup is costly, biofuels के बारे में, setup is costly, एक बार setup करने का पैसा ज़्यादा लगता है, but एक बार setup हो गया, उसके बाद at a cheaper rate you can save money, no need of buying from outsiders and we will become self-sufficient, that is the most important thing. Technologically we will be ahead, there will be feasibility, low cost and also employment generation. So I hope you did understand कि कितना सारा फायदा है इसके वजह से. Now let us proceed to the next one, that is the transition test. This is about your Pakistan. अभी इससे भी ज़्यादा ज़रूरी है गिलगित बाल्टिस्तान वाला issue, which I hope we will talk in maybe if it comes in article tomorrow. So the transition test, इसमें बात किया गया है, the appointment of a caretaker prime minister in Pakistan signs its इन इलेक्शन मो, तो वहाँ पे जुलाई महीने से इलेक्शन होने जा रहा है, एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ विच दे वॉन्ट टू बी मोर कंसर्न, एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ विच दे हैव इंस्टॉल्ड अ केयरटेकर प्राइम मिनिस्टर. फॉर योर एग्जाम पर्पज जस्ट रिमेंबर हिज नेम एंड हिज नेम इज नसीरुल मुल्क. द चॉइस ऑफ नसीरुल मुल्क, a former chief justice as caretaker prime minister, has been welcomed across the spectrum. What is his name? Nasirul Mulk. A caretaker prime minister, Justice Mulk, since he was initially a former chief justice, also required to steady the economy. So, inke upar main एक आपका क्या रहेगा भाई साहब, आपको क्या काम करना है, यू हैव टू बैलेंस द इकोनॉमी. व्हाई यू हैव टू बैलेंस द इकोनॉमी, बिकॉज देयर इज अ बैलेंस ऑफ पेमेंट क्राइसिस गोइंग ऑन, बिकॉज see, most of the people, they questioned on China that why are you trying to do this one belt road initiative, most probably because you want to trap everyone in the debt crisis. What is China saying? No, it's not like that. We just want to develop the ancient Silk Route. As a result of which, Pakistan has also gone into the loan thing and they have asked for a loan of $1 billion to $2 billion from China. So this is going to account for the China Pakistan economic corridor, which again passes through Pakistan occupied Kashmir. That is why India has an issue with the same. The successful completion of the exercise will be a positive signal for both South Asia as well as with Bhutan, Maldives, Bangladesh, India, Afghanistan, in that order, all due to election over the next year. So uske baad hamare yahan pe bhi election hoga and then you will see a new political scenario maybe. The last one here is data in the post-truth age. So this article is talking about, are the official statistics released by the government trustworthy? That is what this article is talking about. And anyways, for trust, you use the term trustworthy. You do not say trustful or isko trust kar sakte hai kya, is he trustworthy? So that is the term that you use. So iske baare mein is pure article mein baat kiya gaya hai. So let us talk what is here. The president of Royal Statistical Society in UK, what is his name? His name is David Sveghalter. And he has talked about declining trust in any government, not just about India, in any government statistical data, there is declining trust. So there can be manipulations in the data as well. That is what he is talking about in this post-truth society, where there are creation of news, where there are fake news, where there are alternative facts, where there are alternative highlight without telling what is the entire statistics, right? Aur saath hi saath is data ko aur kis kis kaam ke liye chori kiya ja sakta hai, and then just saying just apologizing is not it, right? But is data ko chori karna, so there are a lot of things associated with this same thing. Teen cheezon pe main focus kiya hai. Number one is competence, reliability and honesty. That is honestful और पूरी तरीके से ट्रस्टवर्दी डेटा जनरेट करना, जैसे कि होता था. कब होता था? इन द पी सी महालनोबिस टाइम एंड इन द सी आर राव, इन बोथ ऑफ देयर टाइम इट वॉज योर मोर ऑथेंटिक, दैट इज़ व्हाट द ऑथर इज सेइंग. ठीक है, और नीचे उन्होंने लिखा भी है कि दिस इज़ हर पर्सनल व्यू, ऐसा उन्होंने लास्ट में लिखा भी है. देन अबाउट द कॉम्पिटेंस, द नेशनल सैम्पल सर्वे NSS कलेक्ट डेटा ऑन ऑक्यूपेशन एंड इंडस्ट्रीज ऑफ वर्कर. इन 2009 इट सडनली स्विच फ्रॉम ओल्डर कोड्स डिजाइंड इन 1968 टू न्यू सीरीज ऑफ कोड्स डेवलप इन 2004. जो ओल्ड कोड्स था वो फार्मर पे एंड फार्म प्रोडक्शन पे एंड फार्म इंडस्ट्रीज पे, दोनों पे फोकस करता था, बट द न्यू कोड्स समवेयर jotted down, somewhere brought down the image of the farmer and the image of the actual earnings. So, ye baat kahi gayi hai ki ye jo change in code hua hai, is it correct or is it wrong? Iske upar sawal uthaya hai. This change has made it difficult to differentiate between farmer and farm managers. Dono ke beech mein differentiate karna mushkil ho gaya. Shopkeepers and sale managers via occupational codes alone. So, there was only occupational codes. So, you do not know इस ऑक्यूपेशन कोड के अंदर कि वो एग्जैक्टली फार्मर है कि फार्म को मैनेज कर रहा है. सो देर वॉज वन कॉमन कोड फॉर बोथ ऑफ देम. देन क्वेश्चनिंग अबाउट रिलायबिलिटी, द रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया हैज अडॉप्टेड एन इन्फ्लेशन टारगेटिंग अप्रोच दैट रिलाइज ऑन डेटा ऑन इन्फ्लेशन एक्सेप्शंस ऑफ इंडिविजुअल. नाउ हाउ गुड एन इंडिविजुअल इज, हाउ गुड हिज मैथमेटिक्स स्टेटिस्टिक्स इज, एंड हाउ गुड ही कैन आंसर टू द सर्वे दैट इज द एनुअल स्टेटस ऑफ एजुकेशन रिपोर्ट, ये कहता है कि हमारा लेवल ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स बहुत कम है. तो अगर आप एक कॉमन इंसान से जाके पूछोगे कि भैया इन्फ्लेशन हो रहा है कि डिफ्लेशन हो रहा है, ही विल ऑलवेज से इन्फ्लेशन, राइट? तो इस स्टेटिस्टिक्स के ऊपर हम कैसे रिलाई कर सकते हैं, दैट इज व्हाट शी इज क्वेश्चनिंग. द लास्ट वन इज ऑनेस्टी, रैंडम सेगमेंट ऑडियो रिकॉर्डिंग ऑफ इंटरव्यूज एंड रियल टाइम चेक्स फॉर डिटेक्टिंग फ्रॉड्स एंड एरर मे हेल्प डिक्रीज इंक्रीज ऑनेस्टी. ऑनेस्टी को इंक्रीज करने के लिए आप क्या करो, ऑडियो रिकॉर्डिंग करना स्टार्ट कर दो चीज़ों का, कि जो कहा है वही हुआ है कि नहीं. नाउ ऑडियो रिकॉर्डिंग इज नॉट जस्ट बींग, इसको आप हर जगह यूज कर सकते हो, इन केस ऑफ दिस ऑनेस्टी और इन केस ऑफ योर the proceedings that goes inside the court, provided in certain case जहाँ पे आपका ज़्यादा vulnerable हो सकता है victim, तो वहाँ पे release ना किया जाए इनको publicly. A nimble survey management structure is needed. National Statistical Commission led by C. Rangarajan, तो उस time पे अब से बहुत पहले तब क्या किया गया था, तब कुछ recommendations आए थे जिनको implement करने के बारे में यहाँ पे बात किया गया है. So this is all about the four articles that we had to discuss today. इसके बाद जो यहाँ पे बाकी के आर्टिकल्स है, जो आपका यहाँ पे इंटरव्यू है, उसे हम यहाँ पे डिस्कस नहीं करेंगे. द स्ट्रेस एंड डिसऑर्डर एंड इंक्रीजिंग इन पार्लियामेंट, तो उसको हम यहाँ पे डिस्कस नहीं करेंगे. एंड अबाउट द फेसिंग मॉब फ्यूरीज इन द इनिशियल स्टेजेस, जब हमने डिस्कशन स्टार्ट किया था तभी हमने आपसे कहा था कि मॉब कैन गेट रियली डेंजरस समटाइम्स, सो that is again a concern, right? तो आज यहाँ पे हमारे पास दो क्वेश्चन है. What is शांगरी ला डायलॉग, जिस तरीके से आपको मिलिट्री एक्सरसाइज, अच्छा ये फेसिंग मॉब फ्यूरी के बारे में ये आर्टिकल आपका था. थुट्टुकुडी कहाँ है, ये सिर्फ याद रखिएगा, वेयर इज थुट्टुकुडी, देन योर आंसर विल बी इट इज़ इन तमिलनाडु. वाई इज इट वॉज इन न्यूज़ रिसेंटली, बिकॉज ऑफ द कॉपर स्टेराइल एंड दैट हैज़ बीन शट डाउन परमानेंटली. तो इतना चीज़ आपको वहाँ से याद रखना है. नाउ यू कैन नेम अबाउट द मिलिट्री एक्सरसाइजेस गोइंग ऑन बिटवीन सम ऑफ द साउथ ईस्ट नेशंस एंड इंडिया, स्लिनिक्स वगैरह के बारे में आप लिख सकते हो. Then you can write about the Shangri-La dialogue. Please write at least one statement about the same. And then the Indian Ocean Rim Association. So what is Shangri-La dialogue and what is Indian Ocean Rim Association? I hope at least in one statement you will give the answers. Also, do not stop sending the motivational quote. Usko likhte rahiye, ek dusre ke motivational quote ko padhte rahiye, like karte rahiye aur share karte rahiye. Before leaving the session, if you did like the video, then please hit the thumbs up button and please share the video with all your friends and let the thing spread among everybody. So that's it for today's session. This is Antara signing off from Adda 247. See you again tomorrow at 9 a.m. for the editorial discussion. Bye-bye.